Hi guys, how are you? Welcome to my Poland in the Lens channel. Today is my first English tutorial, so really first video in English. The other ones I only have in Polish, but I wanna create more and more content in English as well. So what I'm gonna show you today is Luminar 2018. It's a photo editing software which can be an interesting alternative for Adobe Lightroom. As you probably know, last year Adobe changed the licensing model for its software. So today the only option is to pay monthly subscription fee if you want to use Adobe and Photoshop. With Luminar is different. With Luminar is one-time license fee, and what is more interesting, Luminar is right now available for PC and Mac, and moreover, if you buy Luminar, you get a license for 5 computers, so you can use it on 5 different machines in the same time. There is one important information: Luminar for PC and Luminar for macOS, they are still slightly different. So on the PC version, some functionalities which are available for the Mac version are still missing, but there are 3 upgrades which are coming, and with the upgrade I think scheduled for January 2018, so this month, both software will be, I would say, 98% exactly the same. Moreover, later in 2018, Skylum, the company which owns the Luminar, will also introduce new component which is called DAM, Digital Asset Management, and it will allows you to use functionality similar to catalogs in Lightroom. The details are not known yet, but with this functionality, Lightroom and Luminar will be, in my opinion, very strong competitors. What are the main features of Luminar 2018? So of course on the top you have different menus which you can use to call the different functions from, but there is much easier way. So on the top you have a toolbar, as well as you have another, let's say, toolbar or the working space which is on the right hand side. Let's start with the toolbar. So first you have an open button which actually is used to open the file. Then we can zoom in, zoom out using these features, this drop-down menu, like that, or you can use fit to screen. You can also use plus minus button. Then you have 2 buttons to compare image before and after editing. I didn't make any edit, so I will show you later on. And then we have also some tools menu or tools drop-down. One is to crop the image, the other one is to make a transformation of the image. Clone stamp, this is something what you don't have in Lightroom actually. It's more a kind of function which is available in Adobe Photoshop. So it's quite interesting that you have it in Luminar, and then you have also eraser. Let's maybe crop this image first. So I use the crop drop down, and then let's make it like this, so the boat stays in the strong point of the image, in the one third of the image. And going right on the top toolbar, you have one button which opens at the bottom of the screen the presets menu. And here, if you click categories, you can see different types of presets or different presets. Some of them you get together with Luminar 2018 for free. Some of them you can buy. There are also some free presets available for download from Luminar website, and you can also create your own presets. So This is quite interesting. It's very similar to the presets which you have in the Adobe Lightroom. So if I select, for example, creativity presets, then you can see different presets in the creativity package. Yeah, and you can use and apply those presets to the picture. Let's say I can apply this one. And for each preset, I can also set the amount. So how strong will be the preset applied to the image which I'm editing? Yeah. So from 0 to 100%. When I add the preset to the picture, you can see here some new, let's say, items. I will explain it in a moment. So I will clear the workspace, not to make it too complicated at the beginning. So let's hide the presets menu, and in the very last or very right side of the screen, you can see the share image button, and using this button you can share your image using different ways, like email message, or the share directly to some social media platform or photography platform like 500px or SmugMug or Flickr. Here you see the histogram, which you can switch on and switch off. Histogram panel, information panel, which shows you some basic EXIF data like ISO, the focal length, and the aperture value used to shoot your picture. Then you see the dimensions of your picture, and that it's 16-bit picture, so the color space, 16 bits color space. Here I can also switch on and off the layers panel, and this is also different to Lightroom. So in Lightroom you cannot use the layers. The layers you can use in Adobe Photoshop, but here in Luminar you can use layers more or less the same way as you use them in Adobe Photoshop. And each of the layer has a blending mode, like you can see here. The one which is selected now is normal, and also it has opacity. You can add new layers by pressing plus button, and you can add right now actually three different types of layers. So one is adjustment layer, the other one is new image layer. New image layer you can use when you want, for example, to replace the sky on your picture. And then you can use also new stamped layer, which means the layer which you use to clone stamp something on your image. So this is the way you use the layers in the Luminar 2018. And the last part is filters panel and the workspace panel. So filters panel and workspace panel, they actually work together. So in the workspace panel you have predefined workspaces, but you can also create your own. Workspace is actually combination of the set of filters. So if I select essentials, it means that Luminar adds set of filters which are predefined within essential workspace, and then I can use those filters to manipulate my image. Let's say I can use exposure to brighten the image. I can use also the temperature, the kelvins, to make it less blue and more, let's say, and warmer. Yeah. And then you have, of course, highlights, you have blacks. So using those sliders exactly the same way as you use them in Lightroom, you can edit your image. So this is the workspace panel, but in the workspace panel, whatever you select, if you create the workspace by your own, or you make, or you use the preset, you can add or remove filters by your own. So if I want to remove saturation and vibrance filter, I just click the cross button and it will be removed. if I want to change the value of the filter, I just use the slider and you can see the picture changes. Yeah, so let's say the polarization we will use 15%. If I want to set the default value of the filter, I just double click on the slider and it sets to the default value. For each filter, I can also use different blending options, and I can use also the mask for the filter, as well as I can use the masks for the layer. So this is also quite interesting. You don't have such advanced masking, let's say, tools like in Lightroom. You don't have such advanced masking in Lightroom like in Luminar, but it's not that advanced in Luminar like you have it in Photoshop. So kind of in between. What else you have here? So these are the workspaces. Let's clear the workspace. Each time you can go to the clear workspace menu, and you can also add filters. So instead of using workspaces, you can use filters. I will use accent filter, and I will also add the raw develop filter, just the two. As you can see, when you hold on one of the filter, it shows you sample picture and short description how the filter works. So it's quite interesting, and it helps you to understand what the filter can do with your picture. Moreover, if you can also switch on this panel, so the information won't be shown. Yeah. Then I can mark, I can mark the filter with a star on the right hand side. So it means that those filters which are orange and with the star, they are my favorite filters. So instead of having the full list of the filters, I think right now in Luminar you have like 50 or maybe even more filters, I can just select some of them which I used most often, like vignettes, sunrays, matte look, gradients, and so on and so forth. So if you want to close the filter panel, you just close it. Yeah. The AI filter is quite interesting. It just has one slider, and this filter uses artificial intelligence. So there is an algorithm behind which just analyzes your picture, and then if you use boost slider, it basically changes the look of your picture. It usually gets more clarity, more contrast, you get some more details from the picture. As you can see, if I switch it off and on, right now I have more details, the picture is more vibrant. But I also want to use the raw develop filter and just bring up some shadows. I would like to bring the exposure up as well, and maybe also whites, and I will also slightly change the tint. Yeah, so I will make the picture a bit warmer. So this is how it looks, and right now if I click the I button here on the top, which is quick preview, I can see before and after. I think it's also another way to see it. It's to click this button before and after and just move the slider from the left to the right, so you can see the difference is pretty big. And I can during my editing process, I can add more and more filters, but if I just want to keep those changes and I wanna make additional changes, one of the interesting ways is to use the adjustment layer. So my first layer is here, and then I have new layer, and I can, let's say, use a preset on this layer. So let's select the preset, maybe travel mode preset, And let's use clarity contrast boost. No, maybe not this. I think there is some, yeah, winter hues. And let's use like sepia light fade, yeah. So this is kind of more sepia. It's much lighter and it's also faded. So right now you can see without this layer and with this layer a little bit more blue and more faded. That's how it looks like with this preset. Or you can use, for example, Cinema Pro. And as you can see within the preset, Luminar adds some different filters with some predefined values of the sliders. And this is how it works. Maybe right now it's too much, so I can reduce the amount of the preset for this layer. And this is it. So I can close right now the panel with the presets and see before and after. This is my image. So these are the basic functionalities of Luminar 2018. In my opinion, quite interesting, very flexible alternative for Adobe Lightroom, especially if we look to the price, to the functionality features it offers, but also knowing that one-time license fee give you access to 5 licenses in reality, because you can use your license on 5 different machines. This is it for today, guys. This is my first English tutorial. This will be kind of photo editing series on my YouTube channel, but in English. So if you like it, leave the thumbs up and subscribe, share the video with your friends, and hopefully see you soon. Bye bye.